Wardrobe provided by General Nutrition. For the latest fitness fashions, ask for Pro Performance Apparel. Flex Magazine is also brought to you by the Flex Magazine video series, Rock Solid Instruction from the world's best bodybuilders.
Magazine workout. We are blowing up our back today. We're starting off with some lat pull downs with a very light weight to get the muscles loosened up. And we've got two champions in the house today, four-time Mr. Yugoslavia, Nasser El Sambadi, and Daryl Stafford, all the way from Atlanta, Georgia, national champion. We're going to start off with some light back pull downs, and we're going to move on into some heavier exercises. Daryl, why don't you jump in there and get a warm up?
All right, thanks.
All right. Boyer, what's happening in this exercise?
Well, this is primarily a basic lat movement. In other words, this is the exercise that's known to give you that V taper along with chins. But we're using it today as a warm-up exercise for some really heavy barbell rows and T-bar rows and low rows to come.
That's right. Right now we're just using 120 pounds, but customarily I usually work up to about 250. How about you, Nasser?
Oh, I can only express it to kilos, because Europe I'm accustomed to kilos, maybe 120, 140 kilos.
That's about 240, 250,
that's a lot
something
of weight,
like
yeah.
that.
Yes, but only when I'm really warmed up, not
right.
at the beginning.
Okay. See, 120, that's about the weight of one arm here.
How much are you weighing in at?
Oh, no, in the moment, 310.
310 pounds. That's
good,
a lot
Darryl.
Of food. A lot of eating. All right, let me jump
Nasser,
in there.
Hop in there.
Okay, go ahead, bro. Gerald Nasser was saying he's weighing in at 310 pounds. What are you tipping the scales at?
Well, right now I'm about 235.
235. Oh, yeah. Competing at how much?
I normally compete about 215.
That's a good, 215. Decent body weight there.
See, it's again, nice. I'm sorry. But again, we want to point out the fact that Nasser's doing the movement very slow, right. very good. Smooth. Allowing not only to stretch the muscles, but also warm up the joints and the ligaments.
It's a very light weight for him, weighing in at 310 pounds. You guys stay with us because we're going to come back and find out how strong these monsters are. And we're going to keep on pumping it up here at the Flex Magazine workout.
That's it, Nasser. Come on.
Jeez.
Come on.
Take
Squeeze
us home, baby.
The
That's it.
There we
Good.
Go.
Consult your physician before you start exercising with the Flex Magazine workout. Follow the exercises carefully. Exercise at your own pace. Start with very light weights. If you feel any strain, stop immediately and consult your physician. Flex Magazine Workout is brought to you by Body Shaping, the ultimate fitness and nutrition program, and by Egg Beaters. We're good eggs.
Body Shaping is offering this holiday special. Now you can order the Body Shaping Ab Blaster Plus for only $49.95 and get rock hard sexy abs in just minutes a day.
The Body Shaping Ab Blaster Plus will help trim your waist, flatten your stomach, and strengthen your lower back.
This holiday special is for a limited time only. Order the Ab Blaster Plus now, and for only $49.95, we'll include a free workout video and free exercise mat. This ab-lasting workout video leads you step-by-step from a beginner to an advanced routine that targets upper abs, lower abs, and obliques.
It's so easy, so much fun, and it's so affordable.
You can even use it while watching us, a Body Shaping and Fitness Beach.
The Ab Blaster Plus is backed by a limited lifetime warranty. Call the number on your screen to order the Body Shaping Ab Blaster Plus with a free workout video and exercise mat for only $49.95. Order now, and for only $49.95, we'll include a free workout video and free exercise mat.
Remarkably enough, the same engine that's used at the Indy 500 powers the all-new Infiniti Q45 luxury performance sedan. And if the new Q45's engine can compete on the track, imagine what it can do for your commute.
I like it here. I like it here. I like it here. I like it
about this too. So then when we get together, it's a convention.
I don't think all that old stuff about it is true. I think it's big, big wives' tale. I think it's true.
I like it here. I like it here. I like it here.
CK1, a fragrance for a man or a woman, from Calvin Klein.
I like it here.
All right, getting into our first serious exercise here on the Flex Magazine workout. Boyer's doing the barbell bent over rows, which is basically Nasser, the granddaddy of all exercises when it comes to back.
I would say one of the best mass exercises for the whole back.
When it comes to strength and poundage, Nasser, would you say this is the exercise you use the most amount of weight on, most amount of poundage?
I would say yes. This and with deadlifts.
Deadlifts too.
Okay, Sean, you're set. You want these straps?
I'm all right.
Okay. You gotta watch Sean close now, so he has a tendency to cheat. He'll cut you on the reps. I'm gonna make sure. Come on, let's go. As Sean said, this exercise here is a very basic movement, but it is excellent. It's probably the best for adding thickness to the back. That's good. Okay, Nasser, you're
up. What I was trying to do, Boyer, was bring it in just beneath the rib cage, right to the belly button,
right,
without raising my shoulders up too high. That's why you want to keep your back on an even plane.
Keep your back on an even plane. It also serves to take the pressure off of the lower back. And as you can see, he's pulling it into the waist, which affects all portions of the back, even into the lower lat.
And this is an exercise you have to keep a slight knee bend.
That's true.
So that you get a little better leverage.
Well, leverage it, it takes the stress off the lower back area.
That's right.
That's it. Good, Nasser.
How much weight would you normally use, Boyer? I know you're not using the same kind of poundage as you did way back when, but...
Well, actually, I'm training pretty heavy. Normally, in this exercise...
Good job.
I would... We've worked up to, like, 10 reps with 385.
Yeah. Well, he's...
That's it. This is a machine. Okay, Nasser, you can put the board in. Put it out.
Where are we going?
Okay, our next exercise is low rows.
Okay, take us into that, Boyer. Nasser, that was obviously easy. You're 310 pounds, and you said earlier that you work in kilos.
Yes.
How many kilos would you usually use?
Normal sets, maybe with 140 to 150 kilos, six between eight reps per set.
That's a lot of weight. For those of you at home that don't know about kilos, that's 2.2 pounds. You'd have to times that 140 kilos by 2.2 pounds. And I'm not good with numbers unless there's some dollar signs involved. And I know you know dollars, right?
Yes.
All right, here we go. Boyer's doing the low-seated rows, which is going to work more of the middle portion of the back, as well as bringing the lower back into play. And again, the straps come in as a vital piece of accessory to take the emphasis off the grip.
I think this exercise is really very, very important. I haven't used this exercise for a long time, and so I didn't have really the mass in the back.
Right.
So I've really had to do it every time by my workouts.
Yes, sir. It's very key as far as working the middle portion of the back. Am I set?
You said.
Okay.
Yeah, this particular exercise, because you're so locked into the movement, isolates the back very effectively. It forces you to do the exercise very strict. How often do you train back during your workouts?
Once a week.
So you train basically each body part once a week?
Yes, except calves and abs. I train them twice.
Come on, Sean. Come on. A couple more reps. Come on. Come on. Make it work. That's it. Come on, good.
You, baby.
All right, good. Okay, Nasser.
Why do you want me to work so hard? No, at 310 pounds, though, I can imagine that Nasser said earlier he's not accustomed to talking in between sets because it takes him a little longer to catch his breath.
Yeah.
And he's using so much more weight than most people.
Well, just carrying around 310 pounds would be. Yeah, that's it. But he certainly is massive.
Yes, he is. And being from Yugoslavia, we'll get into that a little bit later, he didn't have the tools that we have over here.
That's
and
it.
And that's part of the reason he came to America, to use the better equipment and get bigger.
That's it. Good. Yeah, I think we're very fortunate in this country to have not only such a wide variety of equipment, but the experience and the knowledge from people previous to us in bodybuilding to teach us.
That's right. And as you'll notice, NASA's moving like a well-oiled machine.
That's it, Nasser. Good.
Full stretch, full contraction.
Good.
Good job.
As you see, as he pulls it in, the full contraction. Okay, good. All right. Our last exercise in this back sequence is T-bar row.
That's what I was saying was you made mention earlier that you didn't have all the accessory equipment to work the back from every conceivable angle. What is the major difference being here as opposed to back home in Yugoslavia?
No, you don't have their almost gyms, and you cannot compare with the gyms in the United States, you know. You don't have the weight, the heavy weight, not the variety of equipment. But so in the last years I lived in Germany, they have their very good gyms, but not the amount of really heavy weights like here.
Right, well, speaking of equipment, this is the T-bar row that Boyer is demonstrating here, which is gonna help work, again, the middle portion of the back, as well as the lower back. What you wanna do is get a full stretch at the bottom and squeeze it up as high as you can at the top without lifting your waist off the apparatus.
Okay, you're set.
Is it heavy?
It looks.
You'll find out. That's it. Good. Nice and strict. Again, you'll notice that this really isolates the back, but not only the back, it'll also isolate the trapezius and the rear deltoid. As you can see, Sean goes through the motion. It works those rear delts as well.
Sean has so great triceps, you could normally think he's working on his triceps.
Exactly. Yeah. Excellent.
Flex Magazine Workout will return with a massive back workout.
The Body Shaping Ab Blaster Workout Bench, the safe and effective way to trim your abs, strengthen your lower back, and help prevent lower back pain. The Ab Blaster Workout Bench includes a home gym and a 45-minute workout video, all for only $29.95.
Now, in the privacy of your own home, with the incline bench, you can strengthen and define your abs, strengthen your lower back, and reduce your back pain.
The Ab Blaster can be easily adjusted from an incline bench to a flat bench, and it features a specially designed flexible surface for added comfort. Now, you can get the trim waistline and abs you've always wanted for only $29.95.
The adjustable Ab Blaster workout bench, home gym, and workout video is a complete home fitness system that'll strengthen your abs, shape your upper body, and reduce lower back pain. Call now.
Call 1-800-835-9075 to order the Ab Blaster, the home gym, and the 45-minute workout video for only $29.95. Call now.
I understand the concept. Sports news, updates, highlights, whenever you want them. But why? What is this need to spoon-feed everyone everything instantly? Instant coffee, instant lotto, instant drive-thru, feed-me-now burger chains, instant cameras, instant credit, instant pudding. Actually, I like instant pudding, especially tapioca.
We're into our back workout. We're continuing on the next exercise being lat pull-downs. Again, this exercise emphasizes the V-taper, which everyone is very interested in. You can do this movement, as Sean is doing it, behind the neck, or some people prefer to do it to the front, down to the chest. Either way, it's very effective for working back.
Yeah.
Okay, Nasser, hop in there.
Okay. Yeah, boy, I feel slight difference. When I pull it to the back, I can't use as much weight.
Right.
But it works a little bit more in the trap area when I pull it to the rear as opposed to the front.
That's
where
true.
I feel a little bit more in the lower lats.
Yeah, I like it doing it to the front as Nasser's doing it because I really like to feel that stretch in the lat when you pull down.
Right, and he's got a tough time fitting in there with the length. They weigh in at 310 pounds. Some of the machines aren't designed for a guy that big.
Well, what's interesting is he was telling me for competition he weighs about 250, and then he'll go up, to, you know, as his off-season weight is 310.
Yeah, that's a lot of food, a lot of calories.
That's it, Nasser. Good.
This is only 200 pounds, and like you were saying earlier, you probably work up in the off-season to twice that amount of weight.
Quite right, yes.
How many repetitions do you normally do when you're maxed out at your heaviest?
Mostly between 6 and 10 reps.
A lot of people, some guys, I know we had Chris Dickerson on the show, and he's a firm believer in higher repetitions.
Yes.
He likes to do a lot of higher repetitions, and for that very reason, you see a little bit more detail and a little bit more maturity. I know in bigger set guys, they have a lot more mass.
Yes, but when it comes closer to a contest, I hit maybe one or two reps more to get a better definition.
More burn.
Yes.
Good. Well, what Boyer is doing here, pulling it down to the top of his chest, he's using his back, not his biceps. And you notice that he's working the lats area right here. Good job.
Okay. All right.
Okay, where are we headed?
Next exercise is going to be one-arm dumbbell row.
Okay. We can do a variation of this, Boyer. I'll do it with the leg up on the bench.
Okay.
And you show how you do it.
All right.
Okay.
This particular movement, along with barbell row, is a very basic movement and particularly a mass producer as far as back exercise is concerned.
Yes,
I'm sorry, go ahead.
But I think also it works very good the low lats, especially most people don't have the real mass here.
Yeah.
And through this exercise, you are gaining really mass.
Now, this is normally an exercise you can go very heavy on.
Yes.
I mean, Sean's only using a 100-pound dumbbell here. Wait, let him get the other side.
Okay. I got two arms here.
I mean, What would you normally handle, I mean, even in kilos, as far as a one-arm dumbbell row?
I start with 110 pounds. I do 8 to 12 reps, and then I go up to 180 pounds again with 8 to 12 reps.
Jesus. That's quite impressive. Okay, Sean, good. Again, you can see Sean is using one leg up on the bench, which takes the pressure off the lower back. But this movement not only affects the thickness in the upper back area, but it acts, as Nasser said, it also works down in the lower lat.
Yes, it does.
Okay, Nasser.
Okay, on the next one.
Definitely takes the breath away.
This, is, to me, is always like I consider an upper body squat as far as an intensity in the exercise. Always leaves me breathless.
Right, even more so when you're doing it one arm at a time, because you're concentrating on one lat at a time.
That's it.
Goodness, sir.
What a back.
But again, at 100 pounds, it's nothing for him. He doesn't need to implement the straps.
Yeah.
But as he goes heavier, and you said you've worked your way up to 200-pound yeah. dumbbells, the straps are pretty vital then.
Well, it allows you to be able to hang on to the weight because your grip is actually the weakest link. The back is certainly far stronger than the grip.
Right. What you'll notice with Nasser, like a lot of bodybuilders, they have a tendency to use their eyes as they perform the exercise.
Right.
He's following his arm up, concentrating on the muscle.
That's it. Pull it up, Nasser. Good.
Makes it look easy.
I mean, yeah, it makes it okay.
Nasser, I don't know if you count your calories. I'm not a firm believer in counting calories, but on the average, how much food do you consume a day? How many meals?
You know, I eat 6 to 7 times daily, but nevertheless, seldom over 5,000 calories, even in off-season.
Wow.
Many people think because I'm so heavy, I eat a lot of food, but it's not true. Only 5,000.
Only 5,000. Okay. I think I get by with 2,000 calories.
Only 5,000?
How much money does
that's
that equate
food
to?
For a small horse, you know?
Have you ever figured it out as far as like maybe a monthly grocery bill?
No, really, never.
It doesn't matter how much, as long as you're eating.
Yes. As long as it tastes, it's okay, you know.
Good. Okay. Get it, Boyer. Boyer's doing a little bit more slower, more methodical, a lot more deliberate. And again, what you have to do when you're executing these exercises is put the mind in touch with the muscle so you can feel it.
Yes, yeah, correct, but I think you can pull the barbell, the dumbbell here to the chest and to the lowlands.
Right. You can play with it.
Yes.
That's good.
Okay.
Going into what?
I tell you what, let's work some traps.
Oh, good.
And we'll do shrugs to finish off this back workout.
Okay.
You want me to go ahead and go?
No, I'll go ahead and go.
Okay.
I'll do it this way.
Let's go ahead, get around the other side. It unlock the handles better that way.
All right. Barbell shrug.
The trapezius is very effective and it ties into our back workout. So we're going to finish off this sequence with working the traps using barbell shrugs on the Smith machine. Now you can use this exercise either with a barbell or with dumbbells. That's it, Sean. You'll notice how this affects the trapezius, which ties into the lower, to the back, and the rear deltoid. Okay. Okay, there you go. Okay, Nasser.
You know, this is actually a lightweight, but it feels heavy after you've done those exercises.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
And I usually finish up my back exercises with doing traps.
Do you?
Because like you said, it does directly tie into the back.
Yeah, I always try and finish off with traps and with actually rear deltoid movements as well.
Well, there's several trap exercises that you can do. We're using the Smith machine, but you can also improvise and use the barbell and the dumbbells as well.
Excellent, Nasser. He has tremendous thickness and
development. Well, this helps him. When he's on stage competing in the Mr. Olympia, hitting the most muscular shot,
that's right.
That's what you're going to see jumping off his shoulders.
Good. Okay. All right.
Okay, Nasser, let me just ask you a question. When you're on stage, unlike a lot of people, I'm in tune with myself. I don't really notice the competitors. How about you when you're on stage competing against guys like you've been up against Paul Dillette at 6'1", 275, and you've been up against, shorter guys. What is it? Do you notice the difference in the size of the guys you're standing next to?
You know, I think if you are tall, you're always afraid of the shorter guys, you know? And if you're shorter, you're afraid of the taller guys.
Yeah.
You know?
I'm Sean Ray from Flex Magazine Workout. Don't go anywhere. We've got lots more in store.
You've spent your entire life sleeping in an old-fashioned flat bed, but now you have the opportunity to find out about a better, healthier way to relax and sleep. Get this free information kit about Craftmatic adjustable beds. Call toll-free, and a helpful operator will mail you a free Craftmatic adjustable bed catalog and this special rebate certificate. It's worth $200 off any Craftmatic Model 1 adjustable bed. Why is Craftmatic making this rebate offer? It's our way of saying thanks for taking the time to find out about Craftmatic. There is, of course, absolutely no obligation for calling toll-free and requesting this helpful information kit. So if you have any interest in adjustable beds, pick up your phone and call now.
Call toll-free 1-800-652-0101. That's 1-800-652-0101. Toll-free 1-800-652-0101.
How can you tell who's on the move in the NHL? You check with us. NHL Tonight, the most comprehensive nightly recap of the day's action, highlights, and stories in the NHL. Tonight at 11:30, only on ESPN2.
We are continuing on here at the Flex Magazine Workout, blowing up our backs with national champion Daryl Stafford.
Okay, all right. What we're doing here, Daryl, we got Boyer up here on the chin-up bar. He's using the medium grip, pulling up to his chest.
That's it, Boyer, all the way up.
And he's working the lats. This is the portion of the back just underneath the arms.
All right. Using that close grip really brings that lower lats.
Yeah, the good thing about that, Boyer, is you can't vary your grip on this apparatus.
Right. In other words, you can utilize several different hand grips to affect the back in several different areas. As I was using a neutral hand grip, it affects the lower part of the lat.
Right.
Now, Daryl is using a wider grip.
A really wide
here
grip.
Again, bringing it more of a V taper in the back. That's
right.
It.
I'm spotting him just right here from the back so that he doesn't swing. But if I were going to spot him to help him out with his repetitions, Boyer, I'd grab him by the base of his feet here and squeeze out a few more reps right here.
That's it. Good,
grab the
Daryl.
Feet and
all
just assist him at the bottom, just enough so he can pull his body weight up to the top. Right there to the
That's
chest.
It.
Good, I'll jump in
there. Great, okay.
Okay, I'll turn around
right.
Here so you can see.
Okay.
Hopefully you can see the detail, not the body fat.
Okay. This will give you an idea of the muscles that the chin actually affects. You notice it affects the lats and not also the trapezius and the middle part of the back as well.
Great.
That's it, Sean.
But Boyer, let me ask you something now. I like to do mine to the front like Sean's doing here now.
Uh-huh.
And I notice some guys in the gym love to do them from the back. You can tell me the difference like Sean's doing.
Well, I've always found that if you do them to the front, you can pull up a little bit higher and arch the back, getting a better contraction.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay, that's it. All right. Our next exercise is going to be a one-arm cable rope. Again, this isolates and also affects the lower lat area.
Okay, take us through it, Porter. Now this, again, like you said, it's more of an isolated, kind of a concentration exercise for the lats. And you're not going to be able to use a whole lot of weight because we are on a cable machine. But again, it's almost like starting a lawnmower. You got that's the way I look at it. Just stretch it all the way to the bottom, contract it all the way back.
Good.
He's got his forearm rested on his knee for a little bit of leverage. But again, he's not letting the weight pull him, he's pulling the weight. But he's doing it, which is very important, with the lats and not the bicep. Trying to pull, bring the elbow all the way back.
Go ahead.
Okay, baby, let's rock and roll. Joel, have you done this exercise before in your own routine? I know Boyer has a lot. He's like me, he uses a lot of variety.
Right.
Have you done this actually before?
Yeah, I have done this, but you know, which of course when it's my turn,
right.
I'm gonna show you how I give it a little different variation.
Good. Okay. But that's why you're here. We want to see the little tricks of the trade.
Okay.
You know, you can't get that when you look at the magazine.
Definitely not.
Okay.
That's it. All the way down.
Good, Boyer.
Good, Boyer. All the way down.
You've been a professional bodybuilder for how long now?
Actually, I turned professional in '93, so it's been about a year.
Okay.
And I
but you,
two shows.
You earn the majority of your income from doing
guest appearances and seminars.
Okay.
Daryl also has a private training business in Atlanta that he's very successful with.
Oh,
yeah, I know.
He's a little too modest to admit it.
Yeah.
Just throw that plug in.
No, he didn't want the IRS to know about all that extra income. Okay, show us how you
do it. The only difference I do was, compared to what Boyer was doing, is that I like to turn my body a little more away from the machine.
Right.
So I get even a better stretch, and as I pull it across my body, it gets even a little lower.
Oh, I see.
Okay. Yeah, exactly.
I turn it all the way over.
Twist the wrist.
Squeeze
it's
it
more
back.
Of a rotation now.
Yeah,
way.
And it's also bringing in the rear deltoid here just a little bit, which is part of the lat as well. But it's getting a great stretch at the base of his lats by coming across his body. And again, it just comes down to my famous word, comfortability. It's not in the dictionary yet, but it will be.
According right. The words according to Sean Ray. That's
it's a matter of being comfortable.
Okay, other side.
Okay. Again, here we go. Doing the left side of the body. Once again, usually between like 8 and 12 repetitions. 3 to 4 sets or whatever's comfortable for you.
I noticed over the last year, in other words, especially the last 12 months, your back has improved considerably.
Thank you.
Have you done anything special to bring out or bring the back up?
Yeah, for me, I've just continually paid more attention to the basics. When you start getting into a lot of high-tech, super crazy complex exercises, you start taking away from the meat and potatoes. So
right.
I've paid more attention to the meat and potatoes. This I would consider more of a detailing, finishing exercise.
Okay.
Okay.
Again, on this particular exercise, why don't you come around here, Daryl? We're emphasizing the lower lat area. As Sean goes forward with the arm, you can really see that it stretches the lat out and then affects the rear deltoid when he brings it back.
Oh,
that's it.
Good job.
Very good.
Great.
Again, as Sean said, this is an isolation movement which affects the lower lat. It's a specialty exercise, but a good finishing off movement for a back workout.
There you go.
with the basics such as barbell rolls and lat pull downs, and we're finishing off with a one arm cable row.
Please.
That's it. Good, John. Okay, good.
I'm not a firm believer in high reps.
I can tell that.
Okay.
Let's go over to the next exercise, which we will finish off, which affects the back and ties everything together, which is a rear deltoid movement.
That's right. It's the rear deltoid machine on the vertical 90-degree angle machine, that is. And the good thing about this, Daryl, is once again, you don't necessarily need a spotter. And it's not really a compound exercise because the machine is really designed to hit exactly what you're trying to work, and that's the rear delts.
Rear delts.
This is excellent for when you're on a contest stage.
Right.
You're trying to display your back. Mm-hmm. This is what's going to help you with the detail. Okay,
and
you guys don't go...
Was it? One of the things I've noticed... I like to do this exercise, but it's helped me a great deal in my lower trapezius
muscles.
That's
right, very important point. And you guys don't go away because we've got a few more pointers for you coming up on the Flex Magazine workout. All right, Boyer.
Put it to work.
Give me three more repetitions, baby. Squeeze. This guy's an animal.
I get ready for a contest by allowing myself at least 10 weeks where I can concentrate on nothing but aerobics, of course, my training 2-3 hours in a day and about an hour and a half at night. And I visualize myself being in about 215 pounds ripped condition.
Massive pecs, giant biceps, monstrous legs. Now the pages of Flex Magazine come to life with the official Flex Magazine 5-volume bodybuilding video series. Featuring Arnold Classic winner Sean Ray, Mr. Universe Boyer Coe, Mr. USA Flex Wheeler, Mr. Olympia Frank Zane, National Champion Kevin Lebroni, Ms. Olympia Lenda Murray, and many more champions who will show you the secrets that pack on solid muscle. Learn Boyer Coe's secrets to building huge biceps, Flex Wheeler's favorite shoulder-burning exercises, Kevin Lebroni's chest-blasting workout, and much more. Chisel your biceps, triceps, shoulders, back, chest, legs, and calves. 5 videos, 5 rock-solid workouts to achieve your own award-winning body. Have your credit card ready and call toll-free to order the official Flex Magazine 5-volume video series for only $39.95. Achieve your bodybuilding goals. Call toll-free and order now.
He leads Maryland in rebounds and scoring. Now All-America candidate Keith Booth leads Maryland against Pitt in the Rainbow Classic. Tomorrow at 10, only on ESPN2.
Join the Flex Magazine Workout Club now. We at Flex Magazine are interested in your questions and comments. For the latest on fitness, nutrition, and exercise, write to the Flex Magazine Workout Club, Radio City Station, P.O. Box 784, New York, New York, 10101.
We are winding down here at the Flex Magazine Workout, finishing up with some rear deltoids, which directly tie into the lats. What Boyer's working is the rear deltoid right here next to the trapezius muscle, tying into lats. Good, Boyer.
All right, Daryl, hop in.
Boyer, before we get finished here, I wanted to thank El Nasser Sambadi coming all the way down here from Yugoslavia, now living in San Diego, right?
Yes, for sure.
Getting ready for the Mr. Olympia contest. And like I said earlier, he's keeping his chest flat to the bench and pulling
back
the rear deltoids. Great, Daryl.
Good. That's it. This is an excellent exercise for our rear deltoid and trapezius. There's no way you can cheat on this movement. Okay, Sean, hop in there. That's it. You notice how Sean, when he does the movement, he actually pauses and contracts the muscle in the very back position. That's it. Good, Sean.
But I think he's doing his reps too quick.
Come on,
Sean. Let's go.
That's it. See, he's made a very good observation. Slow that down, Sean.
There we go. Slower.
Okay, good.
Will you show me how to do these?
Hey, make sure you watch us next time. We'll have a lot more information for you. Come on, let's finish up.
He's doing 100 repetitions.
Let's go. Come on, NASA.
Squeeze.
That's good.
All right, 99.
We're glad you could join us today on Flex Magazine Workout. Today, Sean and I have as our guest 3-time Mr. Olympia Frank Zane. And we're going to be training back today. Frank is going to take us through his back workout.
We're just doing some light crossovers. And Frank, this is a unique exercise that I've only seen Frank Zane do. We'll have him describe it when he's done warming up. But it's always important to make sure that you're thoroughly warmed up. And usually what we like to do is start off with the first exercise and do a very light weight for high reps. Good, Frank. All right, let me step in there. I've never done this, so I'm gonna look a little unorthodox.
from the rear so they can see it.
Maybe Frank can talk us through this one here, because I have to be honest, I've never seen this exercise done either.
It's a very good exercise to start with, Boyer, because it warms up your upper lats right under the rear deltoid, the rear delts, and even gets a little tricep. It's one of the few upper back movements that you can do that doesn't really work the biceps, and that's why I like to do this.
Well, it's an exercise, too. In other words, it looks like it gives you a lot of range of motion
in
warming up the back.
Yeah, you don't need a lot of weight to feel that.
Good. It's a lot like pull-downs in a way.
Yeah.
But without working the pulling muscles too much.
Same kind of movement. You're inadvertently bringing in a little bit of the rear delt on this exercise, right?
Yeah.
Just a little bit, yeah. Good. Squeeze it out. If you're not careful, you can wind up bringing in the tricep if you actually extend and flex at the end.
Whereas his arm's slightly bent, which is good, because you do want to get a little bit of tricep here. You get the posterior head a little bit.
Right. Nice little warm-up before we bring on the meat and potatoes of the back routine. Good, just get the blood flowing. We like to work out first thing in the morning here, so we got to loosen it up. We hear a lot of snap, crackle, and pop. You guys stay with us. We've got a lot more muscle action right here on Flex Magazine Workout with three-time Mr. Olympia, Frank Zane. Come on, Boyer.
That's it, Boyer.
Warm it up. Good job.
Stretch it out.
Consult your physician before you start exercising with the Flex Magazine Workout. Follow the exercises carefully. Exercise at your own pace. Start with very light weights. If you feel any strain, stop immediately and consult your physician. Flex Magazine Workout is brought to you by Body Shaping, the ultimate fitness and nutrition program. And by Egg Beaters, we're good eggs.
Body Shaping is offering this holiday special. Now you can order the Body Shaping Ab Blaster Plus for only $49.95 and get rock-hard, sexy abs in just minutes a day.
The Body Shaping Ab Blaster Plus will help trim your waist, flatten your stomach, and strengthen your lower back.
This holiday special is for a limited time only. Order the Ab Blaster Plus now, and for only $49.95, we'll include a free workout video and free exercise mat. This ab-lasting workout video leads you step-by-step from a beginner to an advanced routine that targets upper abs, lower abs, and obliques.
It's so easy, so much fun, and it's so affordable.
You can even use it while watching us on Body Shaping and Fitness Beach.
The Ab Blaster Plus is backed by a limited lifetime warranty. Call the number on your screen to order the Body Shaping Ab Blaster Plus with a free workout video and exercise mat for only $49.95. Order now, and for only $49.95, we'll include a free workout video and free exercise mat.
Remarkably enough, the same engine that's used at the Indy 500 powers the all-new Infiniti Q45 luxury performance sedan. And if the new Q45's engine can compete on the track, imagine what it can do for your commute.
Are you like me? Would you rather be playing hockey than working in this office building? You know that NHL Faceoff 97 was rated best hockey game by EGM. Realistic give and goes and one-timers with icon passes. Less work, more hockey!
Sean and I are back with three-time Mr. Olympia Frank Zane. Today we're going through a back workout. Our first exercise is lat pull downs. On this particular exercise, Frank, do you always do them to the front or do you do them to the back sometimes as well?
I used to do them to the back, Boyer, but that's why I do the cable crossover behind the neck, because that gets those muscles across the top of the back. But I like it to the front because I can get a lower stretch, pull it down further, and get more lower lat work that way.
Okay.
And get in there.
Yeah, I've always found that pulling a bar down to the chest gives me a little more range of motion in doing a lat pull down than to the back of the neck. And also, again, this particular exercise is the one that emphasizes the V shape and working the back, and everyone is interested in that all-important V taper.
That's right, Boyer. And if you're anything like me, I like to feel the bar actually hit my chest. When I hit my chest, I know I've got a full, complete repetition rather than a partial repetition. But unlike you guys, I like to do them to the rear just prior to a contest. About 3 weeks out, I can feel it a little bit more. It's almost like doing a rear double bicep pose.
That's very true. Probably involves more of the trapezius.
A little bit more.
Like that.
It can't hurt. So it's good either to the front or the back, but I know that you can use a whole lot more weight when you do them straight to the front.
I don't like it to the back because it hurts my shoulder.
Yeah.
That's out of necessity. It's evolved to front pull down.
Right. Well, that's good. That's why we have a lot of variety of exercises we can choose when it comes down to working a specific muscle group. When you were competing back in the day, was there somebody that you looked towards as far as inspiration for, like, when you were doing your back shots? I mean, did you ever see anybody's back and go, wow?
Yeah, I remember that back three-quarter twisting pose of Dave Draper, for example.
Yeah.
Incredible shot. And of course, Arnold Schwarzenegger, Franco Colombo, Training with them all. They're just fantastic backs.
The golden years of bodybuilding. Let's go on into our seated rows.
Okay, who's going
to
go?
That's my set. I'm just trying to buy time. Okay.
Again, this exercise here affects a different section of the back area. This is more of an exercise for the upper back area, trapezius, and even into the rear deltoids. This is a good movement, gives a lot of full range of exercise. Now, notice on this exercise, Frank, some people will lean real forward and get a stretch. Others stay more erect. What do you find most effective?
I like to get a forward stretch, maybe not quite as much as Sean gets, but I think that's necessary to get a little bit more lower lat.
That's
get
true.
A fuller range of work on your back.
That's funny you say that, because that's exactly what I'm trying to work for, is a little bit more lower lat development, so I over-accentuate the stretch at the bottom. Okay.
All right, Frank.
Now, I noticed that Frank's only using 150 pounds, and of course, he pyramids his weight up. How much have you actually used on this exercise?
Well, this is an exercise that I've never gone really heavy, probably maybe 250, 300 pounds.
But
I find if I go really heavy on this thing, I use too much momentum. And I like to keep the movement very strict on this exercise. This is one, if you use momentum, you can use an unlimited amount of poundage on it. You know? That's it, Frank. You notice how Frank goes through a full range of motion, pulling the bar all the way into his chest.
That's right, with a small arc of the back, lifting his chest up.
I think it's important to try to bring the chest up at the end of the motion to get between the shoulder blades.
To arc it,
That central part of the trapezius.
Frank, in your heyday, what was your heaviest competition weight when you were competing in and winning the Olympia for three consecutive years?
It was around 190.
190. And your heaviest off-season?
200.
And now that you're not competing anymore, you kind of maintain great shape. How much do you weigh around these days?
Well, I weigh about 180 right now. I've recently put on some body weight.
Right, and, just maintaining.
Just feels a little bit better to have that extra body weight, a little bit more power for a change.
Good, Boyer. He's always a stickler for form. If you don't have the proper form, you're definitely not going to work the muscle holistically. Good. Okay, let's go into our third one.
Okay.
Doing some T-bar rows.
You know, it's amazing, Sean, what Frank was saying about the weight of competitors in the Mr. Olympia, say, 15 years ago versus now, where you got a good percentage of the bodybuilders over 250 pounds.
Evolved a little bit.
It certainly has. Okay. Again, this particular exercise is for general thickness in the back. I would think this probably affects more of the meaty portion of the back other than any other exercise, with the exception of maybe barbell row. Do you do this on a regular basis in your back training, Frank?
Not really, but if I had a supported piece of equipment like this, I would. The regular way is just too hard on the lower back, I think. But
right.
I think T-bar rows are unexcelled for developing lat thickness.
Yeah.
One of the very best.
Exactly.
Again, you notice now, Frank is catching this with a little different hand grip than Sean used. He's using a neutral hand grip, which actually affects the rear deltoid a little bit more, isolates it more effectively.
A little bit more of the middle back.
Exactly.
But you can't get away from the stretch at the bottom, the contraction at the top. Again, trying to keep your waist pressed onto the apparatus and use your
That's
back
it,
to pull in. What's it like competing against this guy, Boyer, way back in the 70s?
Well, Frank, I have to say, was always, I would say, the master as far as preparation was concerned. He always had the best tan. He always had the best posing trunks. He always had the best posing routine. He and Ed Carney. I mean, he was a true professional in the sense he didn't leave anything unfinished before he got on stage.
Well, I know you don't have a problem tanning now. You reside out in Palm Springs where it's nice and hot.
Yeah, no problem there at all.
Play a little golf out there while you're there?
Never.
No?
No golf. Don't have time.
Just training, huh?
Yeah.
All right. Put it in there, boy.
That's it, Boyer.
Boyer, there you go. Now, I know you're doing a lot of commentating present day for all, like, the Mr. Olympia contest. How's that as far as your day-to-day thing, getting more involved with the bodybuilding like that?
I love it to be involved with bodybuilding all the time.
Yeah.
I enjoy training people, too, at my facility out there. And I really like working out, and it's great to be on the show and train with you guys.
Good, okay. You guys stay with us. We've got a lot more training action right here
great
at the Flex Magazine Workout.
Okay, you gonna hop Let's in go and get another set? Okay, sure. Good. That's it.
Hi, this is Boyer Cole, and you're watching Flex Magazine Workout. Don't you dare change that channel.
The Body Shaping Ab Blaster Workout Bench. the safe and effective way to trim your abs, strengthen your lower back, and help prevent lower back pain. The Ab Blaster Workout Bench includes a home gym and a 45-minute workout video, all for only $29.95.
Now, in the privacy of your own home, with the incline bench, you can strengthen and define your abs, strengthen your lower back, and reduce your back pain.
The Ab Blaster can be easily adjusted from an incline bench to a flat bench, and it features a specially designed flexible surface for added comfort. Now, you can get the trim waistline and abs you've always wanted for only $29.95.
The adjustable Ab Blaster workout bench, home gym, and workout video is a complete home fitness system that'll strengthen your abs, shape your upper body, and reduce lower back pain. Call now.
Call 1-800-835-9075 to order the Ab Blaster, the home gym, and the 45-minute workout video for only $29.95. Call now.
When injuries are a fact of life in the world of sports, you have to deal with it.
We got a coffee scald.
Every time we put on a uniform, there's a risk. We know we can get hurt. You have to deal with the pain.
Jack?
To the NFL now. Will the Jets be any more offensive?
And the great ones play right through it.
15 Stanley Cups were decided.
And that's the stuff legends are made of.
We're finishing our back training today with some rope pulls. We've also lost Sean Ray for this segment of the show. I'd like to introduce Ed Corney, former Mr. America, Mr. World, Mr. Universe, who's joining Frank and I in this portion of the back program. Nice to have you on the show, Ed.
Nice to be here, brother.
Thank you. This exercise that Frank is doing is a rope pull. This actually isolates, it's a finishing off exercise, isolates the lower part of the back, also brings the deltoids into play. Okay, Frank, good job.
You know what I like about this exercise, Boyer? It's a key serratus movement. The serratus anterior, right in here, join the lats to the rib cage. Now, Boyer's doing this a little bit more with his upper body erect. You get a slightly different effect that way, and no matter how you do it, you always seem to feel a little bit in the triceps. Looking good, Boyer.
Well, if you're wondering why his back is so huge,
I know.
This is one of the exercises that contribute to it. Attaboy, Boyer.
Okay, Ed, you're up. I noticed you spread your hands a little bit at the end, Boyer. Why'd you do that?
You bring it down, you're out.
I tell you what, not really thinking about it. I believe it's more just a habit. I mean, everybody's got a little different way of doing the exercise, you know. This is actually one that I do very seldom, so I was kind of feeling my way through the exercise.
I do this a lot with the straight bar, too, or with a curved bar.
Yeah.
But I think rope is a very good variation for it.
Yeah, this is a good exercise. As far as, like you said, and I've forgotten about that, you really feel it in the serratus when you come down. That's it, Ed. Great. That's it, good. You know, Ed, seeing Ed on the show reminds me of the first time I saw him. He was the guy who, I believe, forced all of us to improve our posing.
Oh, yeah.
Everybody used to come out, stand around, do a little posing routine in one area, and Ed came out with this flashy routine, and we all woke up and said, hey, we better get as good as him, or we're not gonna do anything.
But you know, I followed through from Frank. Frank was ahead of me. So I watched Frank and I said, Now that's what I want, only I'm gonna take it a step further.
Well, you certainly
we all learned from everybody.
That's right. Our next exercise is one-arm dumbbell rows. This particular exercise is, like the barbell row, a very basic movement for not only a power movement, but I would say a mass movement, because it works a lot of the muscles of the upper back. Okay, Frank. It's very important on this exercise to always support yourself with the other hand. This takes the stress off of the lower back area. Talking about back training, Ed, how many sets do you do in a normal workout for your back?
Actually, I do about 7 exercises for my back.
So you use a wide variety of movements then?
Everything.
Good.
Well, the back is the largest muscle group.
That's true.
So it needs a lot of work.
A lot of variety. That's it. How many sets do you normally do?
3 sets minimum.
Three
sets a game.
That's it, Frank. You notice that Frank goes through a full range of motion with this exercise, getting a full extension and a full contraction as he goes through the range of motion. That's it, Frank.
Frank looked like you're getting ready for this coming Masters.
I know. He looks better all the time.
The MC.
You get in shape for looking good in a suit.
Yeah. You guys look too good for me.
That's it, Boyer. Notice how slow and deliberately Boyer does all of his reps. He really gets the maximum out of the negative part of the movement.
Well, you can just feel the concentration he's going through on that particular muscle group, too.
I think that's why his muscles are so big, because of the slow negatives he does and the heavy weights he handles on all his movements.
I'll tell you one of the things, too, that I've always... one of the reasons caused me to do the exercises a little slower is to try and avoid injury. You know?
Yeah, that's one thing that does help.
If you eliminate momentum, sometimes that can save you a whole lot of aches and pains.
No, Ed, that was interesting what you said about doing so many exercises for back. I also do about 6 or 7 movements. It's such a big muscle group, and so many individual subgroups in the back that you really need a lot of movements to get all those little muscles.
Okay, Ed.
Well, here I go.
All right. This is one exercise, I think, along with barbell rows that you can't seem to get away from in any back routine.
You have to do it.
Yeah, there's always one stabilizing exercise, and I think a row like this here, you have to put in a routine. That's it, Ed. Good.
This one pops your lats out from the side is what I like about it.
It's very, very good for the thickness of the back. That's it, Ed. I was just thinking, as the three of us are standing here, and most probably close to 100 years of experience here working out, because we've each been training, I'm sure, at least 30 years.
You know, it's 20 years ago, almost, well, this year will be 20 years since Pumping Iron came out.
That's amazing.
Yeah. We've been around for a long time, haven't we?
Our last exercise is going to be hyperextensions. We're going to let Frank lead us off on this particular exercise, because he has several variations that he's going to show us today on this particular machine.
This is called the Back Revolution, and it's a unique piece of equipment because it enables you to hang upside down and get traction, which I always do before I start this.
This is ideal, and I think this is probably one of the most important things a person can do, even if you weren't training hard. Just at the end of the day, as Frank says, this loosens up and actually extends the spine, stretches it out. You'll actually, if you hang up and down on this thing here for just a minute every day, I'm sure it would alleviate a lot of back pains.
Sort of reminds me of the gravity boots.
Exactly. But this is actually better because you're hanging really just from the hip and not from the ankle. Now again, Frank is doing what we call a hyperextension on this movement. This particularly isolates the lower back area and also the glutes as well. And then again, at the end, finish of the exercise, he's stretching it out.
Coming up next, Flex Magazine Workout continues with a powerful bicep blasting workout.
When I am out here, I am not just flesh and bone. I am not bound by fear or doubt. I am the wind.
Sports, Little Caesars Sports Pizza Pizza. 2 football pizzas, free life-size poster, box top game, $10.99. Harry Dollar, have it delivered.
Pizza Pizza.
From the country that brought you giant fire-breathing monsters, comes something even more terrifying. Chris Farley is...
Goodbye, everyone!
The Beverly Hills Ninja.
Everybody, let's go!
I am a trained master in each of the weapons of battle.
Beverly Hills Ninja. Rated PG-13. Opens everywhere January 17th.
We're concluding our training today with bicep work. As far as the first exercise is concerned, this is called one-arm dumbbell concentration curls. As you can see, Frank is bracing the arm against his thigh. So he's only using the forearm as a lever, really contracting the bicep. Do you normally perform this exercise, Ed, in your bicep routine?
One of my favorites.
Really?
Absolutely.
Go ahead, Frank. You're not going to cheat on us. Get the other bicep.
Yeah, Frank.
See, Frank is almost as bad as Sean. Sean does this to me a lot of times, you know? That's it, Frank. Good. This really isolates the bicep. It's more of a concentration movement. You can't cheat on the exercise like you can, say, for example, with a barbell curl, really isolating that bicep. Okay, I'll hop in here and get the next one.
Blair has that tremendous peak to his bicep, and I think this is one of the ones he used to get it.
Oh, absolutely. As you can see, it's working.
Well, I'd like to believe that, guys, but I think it's probably more genetics than anything else.
He always had that fantastic split in the biceps where you can see the two heads. Notice the complete range of movement he gets. It's like the arm fits right into the side of the leg there.
Just so all the fibers are
perfect
coming out.
Groove.
Attaboy. But you know, genetics only carry you to a certain point. The rest is hard work.
Okay, Ed.
One of my favorites.
I think biceps is a perfect body part to include in, particularly Frank, with back training, because the involvement of the biceps in the back exercises anyway.
Yeah, that's for sure. I always do biceps right after back work because the biceps are worked very, very hard when you do back work.
Yeah.
That's good, Eddie.
That's it. Good, Ed. Great. As you can see, again, Ed does the movement very slow, very concentrated, very deliberate. There's no cheating. There's no momentum involved. You bring the bicep, the dumbbell, all the way up to the top, getting a full contraction.
Notice that he does a dead stop at the bottom of the exercise, really emphasizing that stretch portion.
I think that's one of the most important parts that people overlook sometimes in doing an exercise is getting the complete extension, particularly in a bicep movement. Okay, our next exercise is going to be easy curl, barbell curls. I'll start this particular movement off. The advantage of using an easy curl bar, it affects the brachialis, which is kind of beneath the bicep. And also, if you have a wrist problem, it takes the pressure off the wrist. Okay, Frank, you want to talk me through this one?
I think one of the problems with barbell curl is that you get too much supination when your hands are at the bottom. With the easy curl, you don't have, your hands are not turned around as much, so it's easier on your inner elbow. That's the nice slow negative that Boyer does. Slight pause at the top. There's also a lot of front deltoid work involved in the barbell curl.
Okay.
Get a set.
Okay. Yeah, this is a very basic movement, and I think that along with the bench press, this is a common question that people ask you, how much can you curl or how much can you bench when you first start out? And I think this is an exercise as far as mass builder in the bicep that you just simply can't get away from.
No, I certainly can't.
How often do you train biceps, Ed, in your workout?
Once a week now.
Just once a week?
Just once a week.
Do you feel, you know, we've all been training for a good many years, do you feel that you need to rest more between your workouts? I know I found that I get better results if I take a day off between workouts.
Right now I'm training 2 days on, 1 day off, 2 days on, and another 2 days off. A lot of rest involved.
How do you feel about that, Frank?
Same, Blair. I'm training each body part about once every 6 days now, with the exception of abdominals. And I noticed that, too. Plus, with more rest, I'm much stronger for each workout, and my enthusiasm's higher.
That's the way I feel about it. I've actually gone to a workout where I train every other day. So it takes me basically 8 days to work the whole body. But it allows me much more enthusiasm, and I come back stronger. I think as you get older, probably takes the body a little longer to recover from each workout.
I think that's also why you've grown so much, too.
Well, hopefully something's working. Okay.
Great, Eddie.
Our last exercise is going to be, and I'll lead this one off, this is a unique little movement that I like to do. It really isolates the bicep. There's no way that you can cheat on this particular movement because not only are you working the biceps, but you're also working against gravity.
Can't use much weight on this, so we have some pretty light dumbbells. That's how Boyer straightens the dumbbells out when he goes down. He gets the brachioradialis a little bit more and then turns and supinates as he comes up to get the peak of the bicep.
You can see the results working, Frank.
Look at those arms. Wow.
Stay tuned for more Muscle Building Flex Magazine Workout.
Massive pecs, giant biceps, monstrous legs. Now the pages of Flex Magazine come to life with the official Flex Magazine 5-volume bodybuilding video series. featuring Arnold Classic winner Sean Ray, Mr. Universe Boyer Coe, Mr. USA Flex Wheeler, Mr. Olympia Frank Zane, National Champion Kevin Lebroni, Ms. Olympia Linda Murray, and many more champions who will show you the secrets that pack on solid muscle. Learn Boyer Coe's secrets to building huge biceps, Flex Wheeler's favorite shoulder-burning exercises, Kevin Lebroni's chest-blasting workout, and much more. Chisel your biceps, triceps, shoulders, back, chest, legs, and calves. Five videos, five rock-solid workouts to achieve your own award-winning body. Have your credit card ready and call toll-free to order the official Flex Magazine 5-volume video series for only $39.95. Achieve your bodybuilding goals. Call toll-free and order now.
So anyway, I'm playing jet moto, right? And I'm riding on this jet motorcycle, and I'm hurtling through different terrain. Snow, concrete, ocean, jungle. I mean, when you got that kind of power between your legs, you don't know what to expect. Anything could happen.
He leads Maryland in rebounds and scoring. Now All-America candidate Keith Booth leads Maryland against Pitt in the Rainbow Classic. Tonight at 10, only on ESPN2.
Join the Flex Magazine Workout Club now. We at Flex Magazine are interested in your questions and comments. For the latest on fitness, nutrition, and exercise, write to the Flex Magazine Workout Club, Radio City Station, P.O. Box 784, New York, New York, 10101.
We've just completed our back and bicep training, cooling down a bit, kind of having a rap session, as Sean would call it. Ed, it's been probably, what, 20 years since the movie Pumping Iron came out. Do you think that that movie was kind of the catalyst to make bodybuilding interesting or popular to the general public?
Absolutely did. You know, it clued everybody in, the news media, the general public, as to what bodybuilding was all about. As you can see, I've been around for eons.
I feel like I'm standing next to some three wise men. I noticed that way back when I started bodybuilding, I looked at the older pictures and stuff. You guys all pretty much trained at the same gym. I mean, there may have been a handful of you guys, about a dozen, and all of you guys trained at the same gym. At the same time. And now, I mean, we got Dorian Yates way over in England, Kevin Lebron on the East Coast, and Flex Wheeler out here. We're all geographically dispersed, but you guys seem to still keep that kind of camaraderie, whereas today the money has kind of divided us. Professionals.
Well, I think in our sport, and I don't want Frank's comment on this, when we started, there was no money involved, so you didn't have to worry about it. It was just the love of the sport, and I think that's basically why we're still in it today.
Yeah, we did it because we loved it. And also, there weren't as many people doing it back then as there were today. And we all trained at the same place, basically at Gold's Gym in Venice in the 70s, because that was the place. I moved out here from Florida just to be around the riding.
I didn't make too many friends by having you guys come. They're all jealous of me. But anyways, we want to thank you guys for tuning in to the Flex Magazine Workout. And stay tuned. We're going to have a lot more champions in the future. Thanks a lot for coming, Ed.
My pleasure.
All right. Good to meet you again, Frank.
It was a pleasure to have you guys. It was a real honor to have you guys.
Thank you.
Wardrobe provided by General Nutrition. For the latest fitness fashions, ask for Pro Performance Apparel. Flex Magazine is also brought to you by the Flex Magazine video series, rock solid instruction from the world's best bodybuilders.
Thanks for joining us here at the Flex Magazine Workout. As you can see, Boyer's already warming up the biceps. We're going to bring you today some bicep training, some shoulder training, and some awesome calf training here. But first, we're going to start off doing the standing cable curl. It's a very basic exercise using a very light weight, warming up the elbows, loosening up the ligaments and tendons, squeezing at the top, and keeping the arms close to the body. All right, who's coming on today, Boyer?
Okay, also, Sean, today as our guest, as we're going through these workouts, we have none other than five-time Miss Olympia, Linda Murray. We also have pro IFBB champion, J.J. Marsh, and also North American bodybuilding champion and top IFBB pro, Jim Quinn. That's it. Come on, Sean. Again, we're warming up the biceps before we go into our heavy bicep training. That's it. Good. Nice and smooth.
Get another one. We'll usually do one or two sets just to warm it up, and then come back at you with a variety of exercises to try to hit the bicep from every conceivable angle. This is really working the meaty portion of the bicep here. All right, squeezing it out, Very lightweight, but we're going to come back and add some weight to the bar and bring on our champions. Stay with us at the Flex Magazine workout. Come on, Boyer. Warming it up. Get ready. There you go.
Consult your physician before you start exercising with the Flex Magazine workout. Follow the exercises carefully. Exercise at your own pace. Start with very light weights. If you feel any strain, stop immediately and consult your physician. Flex Magazine Workout is brought to you by Body Shaping, the ultimate fitness and nutrition program, and by Egg Beaters. We're good eggs.
Body Shaping is offering this holiday special. Now you can order the Body Shaping Ab Blaster Plus for only $49.95 and get rock-hard sexy abs in just minutes a day.
The Body Shaping Ab Blaster Plus will help trim your waist, flatten your stomach, and strengthen your lower back.
This holiday special is for a limited time only. Order the Ab Blaster Plus now, and for only $49.95, we'll include a free workout video and free exercise mat. This ab blasting workout video leads you step by step from a beginner to an advanced routine that targets upper abs, lower abs, and obliques.
It's so easy, so much fun, and it's so affordable.
You can even use it while watching us on Body Shaping and Fitness Beach.
The Ab Blaster Plus is backed by a limited lifetime warranty. Call the number on your screen to order the Body Shaping Ab Blaster Plus with a free workout video and exercise mat for only $49.95. Order now, and for only $49.95, we'll include a free workout video and free exercise mat.
Now, the way to save money is less people doing more work.
Time to walk out to OfficeMax. It's easy to cut expenses there. OfficeMax has over 7,000 office products, computers, electronics, software, furniture, at guaranteed low prices. Talk about bottom line. There's great stuff, like compact computers and Xerox paper. You'll save so much, there'll be company cars, bonuses, and big perks for everyone. Hey, I was just kidding. OfficeMax, we go to the max for you.
Beauty, adventure, drama, all these and more can be yours in the wonderful world of art. And with this free art test from Art Instruction Schools, you can find out if you have the interest and desire needed to become a serious art student. To get your free art test without cost or obligation, call this toll-free number. Don't delay. Call this toll-free number now. Call 1-800-344-8300.
All right. We promised you lots of biceps here on the show. We've got the reigning queen of bodybuilding, five-time Miss Olympia, Linda Murray. And what she's performing right here is the one-arm cable curl. It's a spin-off of doing a concentration curl. The advantage of this exercise is, like as Linda will show us, is that you can concentrate everything into the bicep. You don't have to swing the weight up. You can do it slow and deliberate and concentrate at the top. With the cables, you got a distinct advantage over the free weights because you got constant tension throughout the range of motion. Good, let me jump in there.
Okay, show me how to do it.
All right, let me add
show me the right way.
I gotta add weight, you know.
Yeah, macho you're trying thing. To show me up always, Sean.
Okay.
Come on.
Give me some tips on this exercise.
Whew. What I really like about this is, like you said, it's constant tension on the muscle. Good control. And I always suggest this exercise. You know, when someone's just getting involved in weight training, it's hard to make a mistake or injure yourself compared to with free weights. So that's one thing.
How many sets do you normally do?
Usually I do 4 sets this exercise, and I range from 8 to about 12 reps.
Okay.
And I do the 8 reps, is usually have that heavy weight on there. Come on, Sean. Show me how to do it. Big biceps.
All right.
Let's move on into the next exercise.
Okay.
We'll do some seated alternate curls. We'll do them alternate, one arm at a time, and I'll do them in unison. Okay, grab your weight. She's using a pair of 20-pound dumbbells. And again, it's very similar to what we were doing, but we can take a lot of the swing and the body language out of it because she's sitting down and she's isolating her body. So the range of motion is slow and deliberate. If I'm gonna spot Linda on this exercise, I'll grab her just at the back of her forearm and help her squeeze it up at the top. Here we go. Boom. And like Linda was saying, you like to use a weight that you can handle, something that you can get the repetitions out of, trying to get 8 here. Yeah, squeeze it up. Twisting the wrist at the top for the peak. Good.
Okay, come on, Sean.
I'll do them 2 arm at a time.
Okey-dokey. This way it's a lot faster, right? 2 arms. You can get it done fast, that's for sure.
Yeah.
Come on. Good set. Good set. What I like too is the control. A lot of times people work all other types of other areas of the body. Instead of working the biceps, they're working back and legs and everything else. So that's really good. Come on, free weights. Come on.
One more.
Good set, Sean.
All right.
Come on.
Good.
Good set.
Okay.
Good set.
We got a special treat. Lots more bodybuilding information with biceps. Throwing it over to Boyer Co.
Thanks, Sean.
All right.
My training partner today will be Big Jim Quinn. Come on in here, Jim. The first exercise that we're going to do is one-arm concentration curls with a dumbbell. Again, you can do this with two arms at a time, but we're doing one arm today.
Here you go, Boyer.
Going all the way down in that movement, getting a full range of motion. The way he's going all the way down being that he's using the steep edge of the Pecha curl as opposed to the edge is not vertical, makes it that much more difficult, and it puts a lot more strain on the lower bicep. You can see at the bottom of that movement, really hitting a lot of that insertion. Kind of a dangerous exercise to do if you're not really meticulous with your form. So the weight in this exercise is not really the most important aspect. It's really the technique. Got a lot of fibers going on in there.
Okay, Jim, you're set.
I kind of gyrate a little bit.
Okay.
You know, when you get older, you gotta protect yourself a little bit.
Jim actually is hanging more over the side of the bench. Again, here, he does exercise very, very smooth, lowering the weight down into a full extension, coming back up into a full contraction. Jim Quinn is certainly one of the biggest guys in bodybuilding, going up in the neighborhood of body weight of about 290 pounds. So he's one of the bigger pros on the IFBB circuit. That's it, Jim, nice and smooth. This really isolates the bicep, as Jim said, right at the point of insertion. Okay, let's hit that other arm. Again, this exercise really isolates the bicep because we're using the pad or the preacher bench here as a support for the arm. You can't swing the arm up. It's totally isolating the bicep area. Very good, Jim. That's it, nice and smooth. This makes the bicep do all of the work. There's no body movement that you can do, in other words, to cheat on this particular exercise. That's it. Very good, nice and smooth, Jim. Good. Squeezing at the top. The next exercise we're going to do is standing barbell curls. This can be done either with a straight bar or, as we're demonstrating now, an easy curl bar. Kind of talk me through this one, Jim.
Yeah. Well, the easy curl bar, as opposed to doing with a straight bar, which most people do on their initial couple of years of training, being that the bar is curled, you can get more supination. And supination meaning coming up and twisting, as we were doing with the dumbbell before. This can naturally, due to the bar being bent, help you to supinate.
This exercise not only affects the bicep, but having the bent bar here, it also affects the brachialis, which is the muscle actually underneath the bicep, which pushes it up. Nice and smooth, Jim. Again, we want to emphasize the fact of doing a very strict movement. You're not using any body movement, strictly all bicep doing the work. You'll notice how very lean Jim is simply by the vascularity shown in his body as he goes through the movements. That's it. That's it, Jim. Stay tuned. We have a lot more coming at you. We're going to be training shoulders, and we're also going to be training calves. Let me get in here and get one more set.
Go ahead. Do it up.
Okay. Don't go away, because Sean and Boyer have more to come on Flex Magazine Workout.
The Body Shaping Ab Blaster Workout Bench, the safe and effective way to trim your abs, strengthen your lower back, and help prevent lower back pain. The Ab Blaster Workout Bench includes a home gym and a 45-minute workout video, all for only $29.95.
Now, in the privacy of your own home, with the incline bench, you can strengthen and define your abs, strengthen your lower back, and reduce your back pain.
The Ab Blaster can be easily adjusted from an incline bench to a flat bench, and it features a specially designed flexible surface for added comfort. Now you can get the trim waistline and abs you've always wanted for only $29.95.
The adjustable Ab Blaster workout bench, home gym, and workout video is a complete home fitness system that'll strengthen your abs, shape your upper body, and reduce lower back pain. Call now.
Call 1-800-835-9075 to order the Ab Blaster, the home gym, and the 45-minute workout video for only $29.95. Call now.
Security's always been an issue for us here, like any other company. But since we've grown, it's gotten tighter. We're not proud of it. We don't brag about it. But you never know who the hell's going to walk through the door.
I got a delivery.
Can I see some ID, please?
Well, my hands are kind of full right now.
He said he wanted to see some ID, smart guy.
You don't know how crazy people can be out there. It's dangerous.
Next time, have some ID!
Hey, Rob.
Hey, Coach.
You can't be too careful.
We're continuing to pump it up here at the Flex Magazine workout, moving on into shoulder presses. Right now, Linda's demonstrating for us how to do the Smith machine shoulder press to the front. What she's working here is the front portion of the deltoid. It's more of a mass building exercise, and I'll ask Linda later on, because a lot of females think that if you lift weights, you're just gonna grow. Linda, a lot of times, this is a mass building exercise when you put on a lot of weights.
Yeah.
A lot of women at home think that all they have to do is touch a weight and they'll grow.
Oh no,
it's a little more complex than that.
Yeah, a lot more complicated than that, that's for sure. That's the case, and I think everybody, Miss Olympia, or,
yeah,
you know what
right.
I mean?
Give me some more weight on there, because I'm trying to grow. Are you training for size or strength or definition in your training nowadays?
I train for size. If you have that perfect symmetry, try my best. You
I'll
know?
Do it to the rear.
But definition comes through the diet for me. Okay, come on, Sean.
Describe this.
Look at this. See those big, huge deltoids, and you're working the front of the deltoid. He changed it up, and he's facing the back. Come on, good set. Good set. Come on, Sean. Come on. Brace it. Uncrown Mr. Olympia.
I don't like the back support. I like to just, you know, concentrate on the front delt, so I turn around and do it to the rear.
Okay.
A little different.
We're going to move on to the rear deltoids.
We're going to use a machine here that is designed specifically for the back portion of the shoulder girdle, which is the rear deltoids right in here. And what Linda's doing is she's using a circular motion. The machine is already fixed in that position so that you don't have to worry about your range of motion. You want to pull it back with your shoulders, not with your arms. Your hands are just hooks onto the bar, and we're working the rear deltoid portion right in here. And you can see Linda's noted for her deltoids and her back development, and just squeeze it at the back.
Good.
Keeping the chest pressed up against the apparatus there so that you're working nothing but rear deltoids.
Woo.
Is that heavy?
Yes. Now, what do you want to make
I need
it,
more. Give
you
me
need
more.
Like,
I can't have my friends talking about me being a lightweight. Okay.
Okay, come on, Sean.
How important is rear delts as far as the overall physique?
Oh, God. Rear delts are very important because when you do that back double bicep, you see everything. Not just the back, but the back of the deltoids, and that adds a great deal. So if you want a complete back, you definitely have to get those rear delts. Come on, Sean. You can do it. Show them. Come on. Show them how you get those big delts.
Four.
Come on.
Okay. Good. I'm going to throw it over
it's
to Bora.
I'm going to throw it over to Bora and have him give us a couple more tips on training.
Okay. Thanks, Sean. As far as our deltoid training is concerned, my partner today is top IFBB pro J.J. Marsh. The first exercise we're going to do is cable lateral raises, one arm at a time for the lateral head of the deltoid. As you can see, this particular exercise really isolates, you know, the lateral head of the deltoid. By using a cable, we also get continuous tension on the muscle at all times. That's it, J.J. Nice and smooth. Good. This is a particular exercise that's very important for giving that illusion of width. Gives a nice roundness to the deltoids. That's it. Okay, let's get on to the other one. Good. As you notice, he goes through a full range of motion from the bottom all the way to the top. And you notice it actually comes across his body at the bottom, getting a greater range, even more possible than you could get with a dumbbell. That's it, JJ. Nice and smooth. Okay, let me get it.
Can't get some. Okay.
All right, boy, let's get going.
How many times a week do you train shoulders?
I usually get shoulders like twice a week. I'm really working on a high repetition routine. You know, I really find this exercise to be one of the great exercises to work as far as getting a good full range of motion and isolating that area to bring out more definition. It's something that a beginner would want to start to do prior to doing a dumbbell exercise and warming up the shoulders and really bringing out the delts and putting more width and size to it.
Yeah, I always felt this a lot more than doing it with a dumbbell because you can get continuous tension on the muscle itself.
It's a good exercise to do, a good range of motion that you can get out of it. You know, it takes a lot of stress and tension off the, you know, as far as not getting injured or anything like that, as far as working out with the dumbbells and stuff like that. It's a real smooth exercise. Come on, boy, let's go.
Yeah, that's true.
Come on, work it up.
One of the points that you mentioned is the fact that you have to try and avoid the injury because the shoulder, even though it's very impressive, is probably the worst designed joint in the body. Very susceptible to injury.
Because, I mean, with shoulder injuries like that prevents you from doing other exercises, bicep curls, bench press, lats pull downs, and things of that nature. So you really got to be careful when you're doing that's shoulders. True.
Our next exercise is upright row with a barbell. This particular exercise will catch a certain portion of the deltoid region, but mainly it's going to affect the trapezius area, as you can see is very well developed on JJ. As he goes through a full range of motion all the way down, pulling up to about the bridge of his nose. That's it, nice and smooth. This is the exercise that's very important in developing the traps, all important, particularly when you're hitting the most muscular pose on stage. That's it, nice and smooth.
Good job.
Okay.
And I definitely find this exercise to be very effective. You know, getting up, really getting a real pause at the top, putting a peak on the traps, and really making sure that you're contracting the traps here at the top really good. You can also do this exercise with dumbbells, but the most important thing is try to get those elbows really high, as Boyer's doing right here, and keeping that tension on the traps. Come on, Boyer.
Okay.
Good job.
Stay right there. Flex Magazine Workout will return with an explosive calf workout.
I'm going to show you the future of workout.
No, not this.
This. New Endorocks, the natural workout supplement. Whatever your workout, whether you're a mall walker or a marathoner, Endorocks is proven to build endurance, metabolize up to 43% more fat calories, even reduce muscle fatigue. You don't have to do one thing more than you're doing now, and Endorocks will give you a better workout. Hey, the future is here. Try new Endorocks and make it count.
You're the greatest.
Thanks. Take a check.
Sure, Daffy. Just need some ID.
Are you serious? How many big cartoon stars come into this?
Checks are a pain, but your bank has a better way, the Visa check card. And if your ATM card has a Visa logo on it, you've got one. It automatically deducts from your checking account everywhere Visa's accepted.
You're despicable.
Visa check card works just like a check, only better.
What a maroon.
How can you tell who's on the move in the NHL? Check with us. NHL Tonight, the most comprehensive nightly recap of the day's action, highlights, and stories in the NHL. Tuesday through Saturday at 11:30 or after the game. Only on ESPN2.
All right, we brought on a lot more mass this time. I don't have Linda working out with me. I brought on Jimmy Quinn, North American champion, also IFBB pro. We're gonna work on some calves. We're gonna do some calves. Right now, Jim's just loosening up his knees. If you lower your feet down on the apparatus there, you'll see that you can not only do thighs, but you can also work calves. Jim's already expressed to me that he's had some lingering injuries. Jim used to play pro football, and we'll let him expand on that later on. But right now, we're doing toe presses for the calves. Okay, what he's doing is he's got his feet parallel together, and it's just stretching at the bottom and squeezing at the top. Coming up onto the balls of your feet, working the gastrocnemius and the soleus muscles there in the calves. A very stubborn muscle, I might add. A lot of guys have a tendency to train this muscle maybe three, sometimes upwards of four times per week. All right, good, Jim. Good, all right. Again, I think there is a direct correlation to weight and mass. Jimmy, do you normally go really heavy when you train your calves and really light, or how does that work?
Very, Sean. The way I look at calves is, if you've been walking around on them all your life and you've been an athlete and they haven't grown yet, then you really gotta shock them to death with heavy, heavy weight. And the main premise here is the good form. And I think a lot of people set themselves up on this platform and they're pushing through their toes. What I like to do is set myself up where I'm pushing through the ball on my big toe, and I was taught that by a gymnastic coach. That way, that's where the power comes from, the ball of your big toe.
That's right. You got much more support and stability
there,
too. Okay, we'll move on into our second exercise, which is the seated calf raise. Jim, I was making mention that you had a lot of little nicks and bruises here and there from playing football and things. Also, you lift a tremendous amount of weight. I've seen you train.
Yeah, I guess I'm a stubborn old powerlifter that diets once in a while to be a bodybuilder. But the football thing, I wasn't big on avoiding people on the field, kind of like Natron means.
Taking them head on.
The Chargers, and I paid the price with a lot of AC problems and knees and elbows and... I have to train around it.
Good. Well, you're hanging in there very good. We're doing the seated calf raise here. And again, depending on where the foot is positioned, that will determine what portion of the calf you're actually working. You can hit the inner calf, you can hit the outer calf. Jim's got a straight position. Is that working more both the inner side or the outer side when you put your toes straight ahead?
I think it works them equally. You know, if you're going to turn your toes out, Sean, it'll work the outer head.
That's what I'm going to do. I'm going to turn my toes out this way.
Yeah.
Okay.
You know, some guys have more inner development than outer. I'm pretty fortunate, I think, for being a running back like you were, mm-hmm. also playing high school football, where I got a lot of calf development by playing ball for 13, 14, 15 years.
You're an old man.
Yeah, 35 in 2 weeks.
All right, looking good, though.
Thanks.
Okay, let's throw it over to Boyer and J.J. Marsh. Go ahead, Boyer.
Thanks, Sean. Our exercise that we're going to do, the first one we're going to lead off with calf raises on a 45-degree apparatus. This particular machine allows you to handle a lot of weight, doesn't put any compression on the back, and it totally allows you to isolate the calves and get a very good stretch. You notice that it go down very, very deep, get a good stretch, and into a complete contraction.
See, a lot of guys tend to, you know, this is the most unforgotten body part that's worked. You know, when they're starting out, you know, more people are tending to get into this ego thing of working upper body, but, you know, a tip to an amateur or someone starting out, they really want to start with a good foundation and work the calves first and work up the physique, start from the bottom to the top. What Boyer's doing here is really stretching down, really getting a good range of motion on the calves. You can see how it's peaking up at the top. He's getting a good contraction on the muscle. That's really good. Let's go, Boyer. Let's get five more. All right. Good job.
Okay. Okay, you're set.
Let me get in there and get some going.
One of the most important aspects of calf training that I've always emphasized is the stretching part, or the lower part of the movement. Most people have a tendency in working calves, they try to handle too much weight, and it causes them to bend their knees, they don't keep the knees locked, and they also have a bouncing movement on the calves. Every movement for calves should be very slow and deliberate, to down into a complete stretch and up to a complete contraction, right up on the ball of the foot. Calves, I found, are not really hard to develop or harder to develop than any other muscle, but you simply must work them with the same intensity.
Yeah, you definitely got to put a lot of intensity into them, and like I said, a lot of people tend to forget that.
That's true. That's it. Good. Okay. The next exercise we're going to do is kind of like the old standby, and this is standing calf raises. We'll do this one on the Smith machine today. Most important thing to remember in doing calf raises, particularly standing calf raises, make sure that your block is high enough so that the heel doesn't touch the ground when you come down into the full extension.
And this is definitely a real tricky exercise, so you really got to concentrate on your form and stuff like that, and making sure you're keeping your feet real flat, you know, plateaued on the block there and not causing them to slip off and injure yourself. You know, Boyer's pretty much got a lot more emphasis on the front part of the toes there on the block, and he's getting a real good stretch at the bottom, bringing them up and really working those calves really well. Come on, Boyer, get to the top. Let's go. Good job. Come on, three more. Two more. One more. Come on. All right, good job.
Don't go away. Flex Magazine Workout will return after these messages.
Massive pecs, giant biceps, monstrous legs. Now the pages of Flex Magazine come to life with the official Flex Magazine 5-volume bodybuilding video series. Featuring Arnold Classic winner Sean Ray, Mr. Universe Boyer Coe, Mr. USA Flex Wheeler, Mr. Olympia Frank Zane, National Champion Kevin Lebroni, Ms. Olympia Lenda Murray, and many more champions who will show you the secrets that pack on solid muscle. Learn Boyer Coe's secrets to building huge biceps, Flex Wheeler's favorite shoulder-burning exercises, Kevin Lebroni's chest-blasting workout, and much more. Chisel your biceps, triceps, shoulders, back, chest, legs, and calves. 5 videos, 5 rock-solid workouts to achieve your own award-winning body.
Have your credit card ready and call toll-free to order the official Flex Magazine 5-volume video series for only $39.95. Achieve your bodybuilding goals. Call toll-free and order now.
You're lucky. Your worst day is never this bad. The Avalanche and the Blackhawks, tomorrow at 8:30. ESPN2, lucky you.
Join the Flex Magazine Workout Club now. We at Flex Magazine are interested in your questions and comments. For the latest on fitness, nutrition, and exercise, write to the Flex Magazine Workout Club, Radio City Station, P.O. Box 784, New York, New York, 10101.
Thanks for joining us today on Flex Magazine Workout. We'd also like to thank our guests, five-time Miss Olympia Linda Murray and IFBB Pro stars Jim Quinn and J.J. Marsh. We're finishing off with our seated calf raises. You know, we've added a little weight this time. Come on, Sean.
A little weight. All right.
Sean, in your pre-contest diet, in other words, is protein really important to you? Do you pay a lot of attention to the grams of protein that you get?
Yeah, what I try to do is emphasize to everybody that a lot of times they want to start off their nutritional program with just supplements. They don't really work unless you're on a good nutritional base. And that base begins with quality protein, such as egg whites, chicken, fish, and steak. And then you incorporate a few carbohydrates for your energy and your overall bulk and mass and the bulk of your calories, which are going to come from the complex carbohydrates, rice, potatoes, and pastas. All right? Good. Lots of rest and recovery is really essential as well. And then you take your multivitamins and things like that.
Yeah, I've always found that as far as the protein is concerned, you should get at least 1 gram of protein per pound of body weight if you're a hard-training bodybuilder. Excellent sources, like Sean said, is lean meats, but turkey, fish, egg whites, and of course, now it's made a little bit more convenient for us by some products, like, for example, egg beaters already have the egg whites separated.
Yeah, and I eat like 24 egg whites, so
that makes it convenient.
It's a great product.
Okay.
Okay, you guys. Keep tuning in to the Flex Magazine Workout, and we'll keep bringing you the tips and the international champions here on the Flex Magazine Workout. All right.
Welcome to Flex Magazine Workout. Today, my guest is international champion and Mr. Olympia competitor, Achim Albrecht. Welcome to the show, Achim. It's a real pleasure to have you here. One of the questions I wanted to ask you was, how is the training different from in Europe? I know you're from Germany, as opposed to the training in the United States. Are the gyms about the same?
I think the main difference is that we don't have so many hardcore gyms, so it's really hard for a hardcore bodybuilder to find the gym with the right atmosphere.
I see. That's very interesting. Hey, don't go away. We got lots more coming at you. We're going to be training shoulders, triceps, and calves today. Why don't you get another warm-up set before we get into our shoulder training?
Consult your physician before you start exercising with the Flex Magazine Workout. Follow the exercises carefully. Exercise at your own pace. Start with very light weights. If you feel any strain, stop immediately and consult your physician. Flex Magazine Workout is brought to you by Body Shaping, the ultimate fitness and nutrition program, and by Egg Beaters. We're good eggs.
Body Shaping is offering this holiday special. Now you can order the Body Shaping Ab Blaster Plus for only $49.95 and get rock hard sexy abs in just minutes a day.
The Body Shaping Ab Blaster Plus will help trim your waist, flatten your stomach, and strengthen your lower back.
This holiday special is for a limited time only. Order the Ab Blaster Plus now, and for only $49.95, we'll include a free workout video and free exercise mat. This ab lasting workout video leads you step by step from a beginner to an advanced routine that targets upper abs, lower abs, and obliques.
It's so easy, so much fun, and it's so affordable.
You can even use it while watching us on Body Shaping and Fitness Beach.
The Ab Blaster Plus is backed by a limited lifetime warranty. Call the number on your screen to order the Body Shaping Ab Blaster Plus with a free workout video and exercise mat for only $49.95. Order now, and for only $49.95, we'll include a free workout video and free exercise mat.
I'm going to show you the future of workout.
No, not this.
This.
New Endorox, the natural workout supplement.
Whatever your workout, whether you're a mall walker or a marathoner, Endurox is proven to build endurance, metabolize up to 43% more fat calories, even reduce muscle fatigue. You don't have to do one thing more than you're doing now, and Endurox will give you a better workout. Hey, the future is here. Try new Endurox and make it count.
Occam and I have just completed our warm-up for our deltoid training today. Our first exercise is going to be press behind the neck. And as you can see, this guy's got some of the biggest shoulders in the business. Let's get started, Occam. Okay, our first exercise, as I said, is press behind the neck. This isolates the anterior or frontal deltoid head. As you notice, Occam does the movements very slow, controlled, very strict. You really want to isolate that movement. Not only that, it will also, by doing the exercise in a slow, smooth, positive manner, it prevents any type of injury to the shoulder joint. Okay, good. How often do you train shoulders, Occam, in your shoulder routine? How many times a week?
Normally, I train my shoulders twice a week.
Twice a week. Is that about the sequence you train each body part about twice a week?
Yes, about twice a week.
Okay, all right, let me get my set here.
Come on. That's it. Come on. Strong set. That's it. All the way. Come on.
Okay. Occam, in training shoulders, in other words, do you normally use a Smith machine or do you use a free bar when you do shoulder presses?
Oh, I change it once in a while. So sometimes I use the Smith machine, sometimes a free barbell, and sometimes dumbbells.
Yeah, I like doing dumbbell presses too. It seems to get a different hit the muscle from a different angle.
That's right.
Okay, we're going to move on to our next exercise, which is lateral raises for the lateral portion of the deltoid, the outer cap of the deltoid. You go ahead and go first, Occam. As you can see, you can do this particular exercise either with a dumbbell or, as we're doing it today, with a cable. Notice how he's coming across the body with the cable, isolating that lateral head of the deltoid. That deltoid, the lateral head, gives that big cap, wide-shouldered look to the deltoids. Nice and smooth. Again, I said you can do this with dumbbells, actually do both arms at one time, or isolation a little better with one arm at a time. That's it. Nice and smooth. You can see the tremendous width that Occam has developed from doing this particular exercise, lateral raises. Really broadens that whole shoulder girdle. Nice and smooth. You notice how he keeps constant tension on the muscle as he goes through the range of motion. Good. Nice and smooth. Really good. You notice how he's concentrating on the movement. Very, very strict. Occam, I noticed that you're preparing for the Arnold Classic. What's your body weight right now?
Well, right now I have my body weight is between 275 and 280.
Jeez.
And I think I have to come down, so around 255, between 255 and...
So that's what you're shooting at, is a contest weight, about 255?
Yes.
To maintain that 270-pound body weight, how many calories do you have to eat in a day?
To maintain my body weight, I have to eat around 6,000 to 7,000 calories, good food, and then before a show, I drop my calories to about, I don't go lower than around 4,000, 4,500.
Yeah, most people say, wow, 6,000 or 7,000 calories a day, but you have to realize that's all highly nutritious food, it's not junk food. And those 6,000 or 7,000 calories, I mean, how many meals is that?
Right now, I eat 6 or 7 meals.
Oh, 6 or 7 meals?
Yes.
Okay, I sat here. Okay. Again, we're bringing the exercise of movement across the body.
Yeah, come on. Big shoulder. That's it. Come on. All the way up.
Okay, we'll work out of the deltoid. Okay, once you step on this side.
Come on, nice and smooth.
All right. Deltoids, in comparison to, say, back or chest, is not that big of a muscle. How many sets do you do, say, for your shoulders as opposed to your back?
The deltoids have three heads, so I do normally 4 to 5 sets per head, so total 15 sets.
Yeah. Okay. We're going to move on to the rear deltoid exercise. We've worked the frontal head, the lateral head. Now we're going to work the rear deltoid head.
How much weight do you want on this one here? That's good? Okay.
Again, you can do this exercise with dumbbells, but today we're doing it with a rear deltoid machine. As you can see, as Occam goes through the movement, it really isolates the rear deltoid head. Notice the striations as he comes back into a full contraction. That's it. Again, you do a nice, smooth, slow movement as you go through the range of motion. You never want to jerk this. You don't want to injure the shoulder. You want to keep constant tension on the deltoids. Okay, all right, my set.
Flags Magazine Workout. We'll be back in a moment with mass building tricep exercises.
The Body Shaping Ab Blaster Workout Bench, the safe and effective way to trim your abs, strengthen your lower back, and help prevent lower back pain. The Ab Blaster Workout Bench includes a home gym and a 45-minute workout video, all for only $29.95.
Now, in the privacy of your own home, with the incline bench, you can strengthen and define your abs, strengthen your lower back, and reduce your back pain.
The Ab Blaster can be easily adjusted from an incline bench to a flat bench, and it features a specially designed flexible surface for added comfort. Now, you can get the trim waistline and abs you've always wanted for only $29.95.
The adjustable Ab Blaster workout bench, home gym, and workout video is a complete home fitness system that'll strengthen your abs, shape your upper body, and reduce lower back pain. Call now.
Call 1-800-835-9075 to order the Ab Blaster, the home gym, and the 45-minute workout video for only $29.95. Call now.
How much NBA action can you pack into 1 half hour? How much can you handle? NBA Tonight, the ultimate half-hour wrap-up of the day that was in the NBA. Tuesday through Saturday at midnight, only on ESPN2.
We're back with you on Flex Magazine Workout. We're finishing up the last exercise on our deltoid, our shoulder training program. This exercise is going to be shrugs. Okay, Occam, let's do it here. This exercise, the barbell shrug, can also be done with dumbbells. This works the trapezius area right up in here. As you can see, Occam's is very well developed as he brings the bar up. Notice that he keeps the arms totally straight, pulls up just with his traps. He doesn't use his arms in pulling the weight up. This gives a full, thick look to the entire shoulder girdle. That's it. Great form, Occam. Good. That's it. Okay. Now, Occam, when you are doing your, let me get in there and get my set. But when you're doing your shrugs, do you normally train that with back, or do you do it with your shoulder?
No, I normally train it with my shoulders. Okay, come on. The most important thing with this exercise is to lift your shoulders as high as possible, so to get a very good contraction in your traps. Come on, all the way up. Squeeze it. That's it.
Okay, we're gonna move right on from our shoulder training right into our tricep workout. Okay, first exercise we're going to do is overhead tricep extension. Okay, we're doing this exercise on a special machine. Okay, you got the handles back here?
Let me raise it up for you.
Okay. This particular exercise isolates the long head of the tricep. This is the massive part of the tricep, actually where all the size comes from. It's important in this exercise, and the way this machine is designed, is to keep your elbows straight up, isolating the long head of the tricep. You notice how he does this?
never jerks a movement, goes a full range of motion, nice and easy. It's important to do this exercise slow because you don't want to injure the elbows. That's it. Good. Drive it up. Good. Okay. How come in working your triceps, do you train that with shoulders, or you normally train it with biceps or biceps?
Normally I train my shoulders together with biceps on a separate day. Okay. You can see you can get a very good stretch in your triceps. Come on, all the way down, all the way up.
Yeah, I really like this exercise because it gives you a really great range of motion. Moving on, the next exercise we're going to do is tricep pushdowns. Okay. This exercise here is kind of like an old standby. Everyone who started out in bodybuilding always uses this movement as basically a first mass builder in training triceps. Notice how smooth he does the exercise, pushing the bar all the way down, keeping his elbows close into his side, and locking out at the bottom. That's it. Good, Occam, all the way down. Complete range of motion, never want to jerk it, nice, smooth, even flow to the exercise. In training, you said you train triceps with biceps. How many sets for triceps? I know it's not as big a muscle as, say, back or chest or something
normally
like that.
Normally for my arms, because it's a smaller muscle group, I do around 12 sets for my biceps and 12 sets for my triceps. All right, come on, all the way. Squeeze it hard. Sometimes to make it harder for my triceps, I try to hold the contraction for a second when I press the weight down. That's it, come on.
Yeah, I noticed that when you mentioned that, try and hold it at the bottom for a second or two, you really feel it contract
really
a little
good.
Bit harder.
Like
okay, the next exercise we're gonna do here is kind of like an overhead tricep extension with a rope. Here again, similar to the first exercise, it works the long head of the tricep. But you also get a better contraction because you can actually bring the hands, spread the hands out as you go into a full extension. That's it, Occam. Nice, smooth motion. Also, by leaning forward like this, it allows you to have a better range of motion throughout the exercise. That's it. Very good. This is just one of many variations on tricep training. There's a lot of different exercises. By no means we want to emphasize that these are the only ones that you should do. There's a lot of different exercises. No doubt you do quite a bit of different exercises other than these in your tricep training.
Yeah, but I mainly stick with the basic exercises like dumbbell work and French press with the barbell, and of course press pull downs with the pulley. Come on, squeeze it hard. Good stretching, come on. Two more. One. Two.
Okay, all right. Okay, as we move into the last exercise, make sure you hang in here with us. We got calf training coming up. We're gonna try and convert these calves of ours into bulls. Okay, the last exercise we're gonna do here before we go to break is tricep kickback. That's it, Occam. Good. Pump it out.
Bodybuilding is a way of life for me. I was never motivated to train simply to train for competitions. I train just as hard today as when I was competing 10 years ago. So the motivation there is personally to me to see if I can constantly improve to always be better.
You like to draw, or paint, or maybe just sketch and doodle. Well, if you do, chances are you have the interest needed to become a serious art student. To find out, simply call toll-free and Art Instruction Schools will send you this enjoyable art test. There's no cost or obligation. Take the test at home in your spare time and mail it to us when you're done. Our experts will review and grade your test. Call our toll-free number today for your free art test. Don't let the wonderful world of art pass you by. To get your free art test without cost or obligation, call this toll-free number. Don't delay. Call this toll-free number now. Call 1-800-233-0500. That's 1-800-233-0500.
Security's always been an issue for us here, like any other company. But since we've grown, it's gotten tighter. We're not proud of it. We don't brag about it. But you never know who the hell's going to walk through the door.
I got a delivery.
Can I see some ID, please?
Well, my hands are kind of full right now.
He said he wanted to see some ID, smart guy.
You don't know how crazy people can be out there. It's dangerous.
Next time, have some ID!
Hey, Rob.
Hey, Coach.
You can't be too careful.
Hey, we're coming back at you with a super heavy-duty calf training program. First exercise we're going to do is an old standby to work calves, build massive calves, and that standing leg press. Okay, Occam, you're up first. That's it. You'll notice in doing calf raises, we're up on a block high enough that the heels, no matter how far down you come, can't touch the ground. It's very important in calf training to get a complete extension, a complete stretch to the muscle. You don't want to do any little short range motions. Complete repetitions each time. Normally in calf training, you use higher reps, 12 to 15 reps, as opposed to 8 or 10 reps for other body parts. Now, Occam, I know a lot of guys train calves almost every day. I mean, do you train calves, more frequently than other body parts?
No, I train calves like every other body part twice a week. Okay, go all the way up, all the way down. Hoyer has one of the best calves in the business, and you really can see here how this calf works.
Okay. Okay, the next exercise we're going to do is calf raises, toe presses on the leg press machine. Okay, up and down. This is a movement that you can really pile on a lot of weight because there's no pressure, no compression to the lower back as in standing calf raises. Here again, he places the ball of his foot right on the edge of the platform to get a good stretch. You notice that he keeps his knees locked, comes all the way back for a good stretch, and presses out. You notice that he does it with his feet straight ahead. Now you can vary your foot position. We'll talk about that. I'll ask Occam in just a second why he likes to do them with his feet straight ahead. That's it, all the way, good. Now, Occam, I noticed that you had your feet straight ahead. Do you vary your foot positions to catch different parts of the calf?
No, I tried it before, but I found out that this works best for me because I like to keep it as simple as possible, and in this position, I feel strongest.
Okay. See, I like doing mine with my feet turned slightly out. Seems to work the inner head of the calf for me better.
A lot of people do this. Okay, come on. All the way up, come on. Squeeze it. Come on, two more. One, two.
All right. How many sets do you do for your calves?
Normally 12 to 15 sets.
So you do
totally
keep the sets pretty high.
Yeah.
Okay, we're moving on to our last exercise in the calf training program. Today we're going to use a unique little machine with a 45-degree angle to it. This, again, allows you to do an extreme stretch. I want to emphasize the fact that in building big calves, the stretch portion of the exercise is very, very important. You notice how high he can come up and also how low he's able to come down in the down position to really stretch the calves. That's it, Occam. Good. Knock out about 15 reps on this. That's it. Notice also he's keeping his body totally erect, keeping his knees locked,
so he doesn't bring the quads into play at all. It's strictly the calf muscle doing all the work. Very, very strict. You want to get have a nice fluid motion, not a jerky motion on doing the calf exercises. You want to feel it all the way through the movement. Do you normally train calves with a machine like this? Do you have a machine like this in your gym? Or what do you normally do for calves?
No, I'm not that lucky to have a machine like this in my gym. So I stick with the basic exercises like standing calf raises and seated calf raises. Okay, come on.